just the magical nature of this place, just walking through this place, all of you, someday in the next few years, you must make this trip to Hampi. It is one of the most magical places. There is a Tungabhadra River, today it is dammed. These are Tunga and Bhadra. This was the main source of agricultural wealth for this nation because Vijayanagara Empire was one of the few which learned how to irrigate land from the rivers. Between these two rivers is what Vijayanagara Empire is. But today these two rivers have merged and there is a dam which is called as Tunga and Bhadra, Tungabhadra Dam, which irrigates large tracts of Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. These two states enjoy this water. And this is also a very rich mining place. This is very rich iron ore, and a whole lot of the place's wealth right now comes from mining. Gold mining is also close by. And there are many sages and saints who settled in this place in the past, many yogis. Raghavendra is one of the most celebrated sages of this area. Madhvacharya had a big influence in this area. Vidyaranya is a kind of a inspiration behind Vijayanagara kingdom. Above all, the engineering, the aesthetic. There is a place that Krishnadevaraya built. One thing is the Virupaksha temple, which is a fantastic place. Another is a temple with the musical columns, just columns like this, much thinner. If you just do this, there are seven columns which bring out seven notes of the music. Just with your knuckles, if you do this, it brings out those things. Probably we will put in the archive those things, but these days they're not letting you knock it because too many people knocking it down. But actually, I have been there in the past. You can actually get seven notes in seven different columns just by tapping with your knuckles. Any amount of things we can say about this, unless you really drink in this place. This is not a place that you just, like a tourist, you come and go. This is something that you have to really soak it in. It's something that grows upon you very slowly. And you'll get stoned by this beauty. It's full of stones. They want to show you the shots of the temple. I hope it works. Krishnadevaraya was a great sponsor and admirer of art and music, particularly the classical dancers. And one of the highlights of his life is that he was deeply in romantic engagement with a dancer who's called Nagala Devi. And he built a whole city for her. Initially, the Vijayanagar was essentially called Nagalapuri. It was built for her. So this was his expression of romance, and you will see dancers carved all over the place, and everywhere you'll see images of dancers because he was a great admirer of dance and music. And during his time, these art forms evolved in a big way. You see the rocks, the whole place is with, you know, with these kind of rocks everywhere. You see the Virupaksha temple tower behind us. This is something you must show on the camera, this rock and this temple here. So, you will see many niches like this, small temples built into the rocks. So during his time, art and music developed in a big way. He was also, it is during his time because he went down south and he also ruled the Tamil Nadu, what is presently Tamil Nadu. The Siddha Vaidya evolved in a big way, and a great admirer of this traditional thing. And they say that the battles that he fought, the injuries and things to handle the, you know, the battle wounds of his soldiers, they developed thousands and thousands of Siddha and Ayurveda doctors who treated the injured soldiers, and the level of recovery that they had is supposed to be way beyond what other armies could afford because he had developed thousands of doctors who could treat his soldiers, and there's a whole lot of information about how amputations were handled and how deep injuries and severed limbs were fixed and by the Siddha doctors. All these columns standing here for over 400 years or 500 years and speaking their own language. There's a whole lot of restoration going on. They had… they say that this was the largest market on the planet at one time, running for over the marketplace, one stretch, I think I can show you that. You see those two-storied columns there, can you see that? This is the marketplace, running for about 2.5 miles on both sides of the street, and two-storied marketplace running right across with about 80 to 100 feet wide road in the center. They said this was the largest marketplace on the planet for those days. Thank you very much for all of you being on this journey with me, and here we are.